Now, if you think about it, when we do our LU factorization with pivoting as we just described, what we really are doing is we start with matrix A, we then compute a first pivot matrix, P0, then we compute a Gauss transform L0, then we compute another pivot matrix and another Gauss transform, and so forth. Right? And the end result is the matrix U. Now, unfortunately, it doesn't now look like a clean LU factorization because we have all of this interleaving of application of a Gauss transform with the application of pivot matrices, permutations. All right, well, we can write this alternatively as A is equal to, and then we get U with first Ln inverse, Ln minus 1 inverse, and then remember these permutation matrices are very special. They swap two rows only, and therefore actually they are their own inverse. And we can write this as this right here. Okay? Through some homework, you're going to show that actually this right here, because these are Gauss transforms and they're very special Gauss transforms, all of this can be rearranged so that all of the pivoting happens up front. And then new Gauss transforms, L0 star, L1 star, and so forth, Ln minus 1 star, end up to the left of matrix U. And then if you multiply all of those together in the exact same way that we did before, where we just place the multipliers in the right spot in the matrix below the diagonal, then this actually ends up being the true lower triangular matrix. And if we then go and we bring all of these permutation matrices back to the left, what you find is that you could have permuted matrix A up front and then computed its LU factorization, and that's exactly what would pop out. Okay, so this goes back to, as we're encountering situations where we need to swap two rows, if only we had been smart enough up front to arrange the equations in the right order, then we wouldn't have had to do that.